Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 5.54 that is taken from chapter number 5, Analysis and Design of Beam for Bending, and book name is Mechanics of Material by Beer and Johnston, 6th edition. So statement is draw the shear and bending moment diagram for the beam and loading shown and determine the maximum normal stress due to bending. So you can see this is overhanging beam AB having uniformly distributed load from A to C, and its magnitude is 2 kips per feet, and at point B we have a point load of 6 kips, and this is wide flange beam which is W88 into 31. The total length of the beam is 14 feet, so you have to determine the shear force and bending moment diagram. So let's start with the solution. What will be the first step is that if you remove this pin support at point A, so you will be having a vertical reaction force which is A, and if you remove this roller support at point D, so you will be having a vertical reaction force which is D. So we'll find this A and D by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium that we will use here is sum of all moment about point D is equal to zero, and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So first force that is producing moment about this point D is this force which is A, and perpendicular distance is 12, and this is producing clockwise movement, so it will be negative. So I will write minus 12 times A. The second moment is produced due to this distributed load, and this distributed load when converted into point load, so it will be 2 multiplied by 6, and that will be equal to 12 kips, and it will act at a distance of 3 from C to midpoint or from A to midpoint. So this is 3 feet. So from this midpoint till this D, this will be 9 feet, and this is producing counterclockwise movement, so it will be positive. So I can write it plus 12 into 9. The last moment that is produced due to this force 6 kip, and the perpendicular distance is 2 feet, and this is producing clockwise movement, so it will be negative. So I can write it minus 6 times 2 is equal to 0. So from here we will get 12A plus 12 into 9 is 108 minus 12 is equal to 0. So 108 minus 12 will give you 96. So 12A plus 96. Okay, this is minus 12. Minus 12 plus 96 is equal to 0. So it means that A is equal to 96 divided by 12. And when you calculate it, so 96 divided by 12 will give you 8 kips. So 8 kips. The vertical reaction force at A is 8 kip. Now we will find the second force D by using another equation of equilibrium. So that equation is, you can take sum of all moment about point D is equal to 0, or you can also take sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to 0, and upward force is taken as positive. So A, which is 8, is upward, minus this 12 kilonewton that is downward, plus D minus 6 is equal to 0. So 8 minus 12 is minus 4, and minus 6 is minus 10. So D is equal to 10 kips. Now you have both these forces. So what we will do is that we will find the shear force and bending moment diagram. But for that, I have to draw the vertical lines from the end of this beam. So I will take the vertical line from the end of beam, and then there will be a horizontal line which will show you the length in feet, x in feet. Okay, on y-axis you will be having V, shear force having unit kips. Okay, what we will do is that for shear force, you can see at point A we have only A, which is 8 kips. So I can write it that VA is equal to 8 kips. Now what will be shear force at point C? So this will be your point C. this will be your point C, and this will be your point D. Okay. So at point C, V shear will be equal to, V shear will be equal to V A, which is actually 8, V A, which is 8, plus this force, 12 kips, because 6 into 2 into 6 will give you minus 12. So 8 minus 12 will give you minus 4 kip. Now from C to D, you can see you do not have any other force between C to D. So VC will be V to C, C to D shear force will remain minus 4 kips. And from last D to B, D to B, V will be equal to VA plus VC plus VD, and that will be equal to minus 4, because V, this is minus 4 plus this 10, and VD is 10, and that will give you 6 kips. You can draw the shear force without this, but I have drawn it for your understanding. So let's plot this shear force diagram. For that, what we will do is that let's take each division is equal to 2 kips. So 2, 4, 6, and 8. Similarly, minus 2, minus 4, minus 6, and so on. At first point, we will have VA, which is how much? Which is 8 kip. You can see this is 8 kip. So your shear force start at this point. This is 8 kip. At point C, we have shear force minus 4 kip. So shear force at this point is this one, minus 8. And again, you can see that the load from A to C is distributed load, having is a flat line with 0 degree. So bending moment will be 1 degree higher. And since this is downward negative, so we can join these two lines by using first degree line or straight line, and slope will be decreasing. Now from C to D, the shear force remains same, minus 4 kips. So from C to D, it will remain same. Sorry, this is not minus 8, this is minus 4. Okay. And at D, we have 6 kips load. So at D, it is 6 kip. So this is 6 kip. So shear force will change from minus 4 to 6. And from D to B, there is no other force. So it will remain horizontal. And at the end, you can see at B, we have minus 6, which will bring it to 0. So this is your shear force diagram. Now we will draw the bending moment diagram. So for bending moment diagram, again, I have to draw a horizontal line to show X, and that will be in feet. On y-axis, you will having moment there, that is having unit kips into feet. Okay. What we will do, as we know that area under shear force diagram gives you bending moment. Clear? So we will take the area under each area under the shear force diagram, and we will find the bending moment. So from A to E, you can see this is your point A, this was your C, and this is your D point, and this is your B point. Now at this point where this interact, like this point is E point. So we will take the first area is under the shear force diagram is from A to E is this area. And you can see this is a triangle. So its height is 8 and base is not known. Okay. So I will tell you that it will be how much we do not know about this. Since we do not know this distance, so what we will do is that we will calculate it first. So let I take this distance from this point till this point. This let we take this distance is equal to small e. So this distance from this till this point, This will be equal to how much? You can see that from this to this, this is 6 feet and this is E. So remaining this distance will be equal to 6 minus E. So I will write it as this distance is 6 minus E. Now you can see you have two right angles triangles. So one is this one, one is this one, and another one is this one, and the ratio of their side will be equal. So I will take E divide by, if I take E divide by 8, let me show you, E divide by 8, that will be equal to 6 minus E divide by 4. So 6 minus E divide by 4. So you can calculate it, 4E will be equal to 48 minus 8E. So 4E plus 8E is equal to 48. So 12E is equal to 48. So E will be equal to 4 feet. 4 feet. So it means that this distance is equal to 4 feet. So remaining this E minus E will be equal to 2 feet, because E is 4. So 6 minus 4 is 2 feet. Now we can draw the area under the shear force diagram to get the bending moment. So what I will do is that we know that area under AE is this one, clear, and this area I can write it that area under the shear force diagram is, since it is triangle, so 1 over 2, base is 4 and height is 8. So that will give you 16 kip into feet. Now from E to C, you can see that from E to C, the area under the shear force diagram is this area, and this is also a triangle. So height is minus 4 and base is 2 feet. So again, I will write is integral of V into dx will give you area. So 1 over 2 minus 4 into 2. And that will give you minus 4 kips into feet. From C to D, from C to D, you can see this is the, from C to D, area under the shear force diagram is this area. So this height is minus 4, and from C to D distance is 6 feet. So I will write it integral of V into dx will give you area, that will be equal to minus 4 times 6, and that is minus 24 kips into feet. And from last D to B, D to B. So from D to B, you can see this is D to B. The area under the shear force diagram is this area. So this height is 6 and this width is 2 feet. So I will write integral of V into dx is equal to 6 into 2, which is equal to plus 12 kips into feet. Okay, now we'll move toward the bending moment. And you can see that at start, the bending moment will be 0 at this point. So bending, because x is equal to 0, so MA is equal to 0. At point E, the bending moment will be equal to bending moment at point A, which is 0, plus area under the bending moment diagram, which is 16, from A to E. So it will be 16 kip into feet. At point C, moment will be equal to ME. ME is 16, plus the area from C, E to C, which is minus 4. And that will give you plus 12 kips into feet. At point C, sorry, at point D, you have moment will be equal to MC, which is net moment at till point C, and that is 12 feet. And moment about from C to D is minus 24. So that will give you minus 12 kips into feet. And at point E, you can see you have moment will be equal to MD, which is minus 12, plus moment from D to B is plus 12, which will give you 0 kips into feet at point E. Now we'll plot all these points to get the bending moment diagram. So for that, what I will take is that let each division is equal to 5, so 10 kips per feet, 10 kip into feet, 15. Similarly, minus 5 minus 10 and minus 15. Okay, at point A, the moment is 0, and at point E, this is your point E, at this moment is 16 kips. So it will be like this. This will be the point. What will be point at point C? Moment is plus 12. So this is your point C, and this will be your plus 12. It'll be somewhere here. Okay. At point D, D is this point. You can see this is D point, this is C, this is E. So at point D, the moment is minus 12. So it will be somewhere here. This is your minus 12. And at point B, E, sorry, this is your point B, not E. It will be 0. Okay. So 16, this is 12. Now, how will join these two points? That will be defined by the shear force. Now, you can see shear force is 1 degree line and slope is decreasing. So, bending moment will be a curve and it will be in clockwise direction. So, we will get this curve. And same is the case, the shear force is a vertical, 1 degree line with slope is decreasing. So, you will have to join these two points in clockwise direction. So, bending moment will be like this. Now, from C to D, the shear force is a horizontal line with 0 degree. So, bending moment will be 1 degree higher and this area is negative layer. So, what we will do is that we will join these two lines by using straight line or 1 degree line. Okay. And the last shear force is this one, which is also horizontal line with 0 degree and this area is positive. So, bending moment will be 1 degree higher. It will be a straight line and slope will be increasing. So, this will be your bending moment diagram. So, we have drawn and we have covered the first part to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. Now, in second part, we will move toward determine the maximum normal stress due to bending. So, we know that in part B, maximum normal stress due to bending. As we know that maximum normal stress due to bending is equal to maximum bending moment mod divided by section modulus, and we have been given that this is W8 by 31 wide flange steel. So from the bending moment diagram, you can see the maximum value of bending moment is 16 kips into feet. So I will write it, maximum bending moment is equal to 16 kip into feet. So we will convert this into inch. So 16 multiplied by 12 kips into inch, because 1 foot is equal to 12 inch. So 16 multiplied by 12 will give you 192. So maximum bending moment is equal to 192 kips into inch. Now, what about section modulus? For section modulus, we have to go to the book and we will go at the end where we have properties of roll steels, appendices C. So, in appendices C, you have to go to check W8 by 31. Okay. So, here you can see this is W8 and this is 31. So, in this line, you have to go and you have to search. This is SX, section modulus. So, 27.5 cubic inch. So, SX is equal to 27.5 cubic inch. Now, you have both the values. Just plug it in this formula. 192 kips into inch divided by 27.5 cubic inch. So, that will give you 192 divided by 27.5 will give you 6.98. So maximum bending stress is equal to 6.98 kip per inch square. And that is also known as kips per inch per square inch is equal to 6.98 KSI, which is the answer of our second part. And that is the maximum bending stress generated due to the bending. And that was all about this problem 5.54. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.